Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Journey with Vijay Kumar Srivastava. Today we are going to cover the topic agroclimatic zones of Jharkhand, rainfall patterns and abiotic stresses. First I would like to introduce myself. I am Vijay Kumar Srivastava. I have done my MSc from G.V. Pant University of Agriculture and Technology with a specialization in agronomy and presently working as a seed professional in one of the MNC. Hope this presentation will be very useful to the candidates who are preparing for agriculture competitive exams and general competitions. I would like to get feedback from all of you to make further improvements in my next coming presentations. So let's move to the presentation.
Here we will get the information about Jharkhand in brief. Jharkhand was carved out of Bihar as 28th state of Indian Republic on 15th November 2000. Jharkhand is usually rich in minerals and natural resources. About 75% people of Jharkhand live in rural areas. Agriculture including allied enterprises is poorly developed in Jharkhand. About 1/3 population of the state belongs to scheduled tribe caste. About 90% of cultivable area is rain dependent, means rain fed, where crops can be grown in case of rainfall during monsoon. Good rainfall and climate favorable for growing most of the agriculture and horticulture crops. Southwest monsoon contributes nearly 85% of rainwater, and accordingly, success or failure of crop production is closely linked with the onset, progress, and withdrawal of monsoon. Failure of Hathia rains leaves adverse impact on the reproductive phase of rainy season crops, due to which crop yield as well as establishment of winter season crops are also adversely affected. The productivity of crops is low. In Jharkhand, the state is deficient in food items to an extent of 51% in food grains, 64% shortfall in fruits, 24% in vegetables, 43% in milk, 97% in fish, 55% in meat, and around 20% in egg production. Only one crop is taken during kharif season in most parts of the state, and fallow lands account to about 25% of the total geographical area of the state. Here we are discussing agricultural status, basic information regarding Jharkhand. The total geographical area of Jharkhand is about 79.7 lakh hectare. Then net zone area is 18.1 lakh hectare, which is around 22.6% of total geographical area. And irrigation area is around 2.05 lakh hectare. Which is 10.6% of total sown area. State cropping intensity is around 114%, and national cropping intensity is 134%. So, state is lagging behind compared to national cropping intensity. Total area under cultivation, gross cultivation is 25.95 lakh hectares. Forest area is 23 lakh hectare, which contributes around 29% of total geographical area. And fallow lands around 20.98 lakh hectare, which is 26.3% of total geographical area of Jharkhand. And cultivable wasteland is about 2.7 lakh hectare, which is nearly 3.45% of total geographical area of a state. Here we have described the status of districts in food security index. The food security index refers to the availability of food grains in a quality manner to provide to the population. But here, as per reports of United Nations Food Programme and Institute of Human Development, there are 18 districts of Jharkhand which bears the testimony of poor state affair in the state. Means Jharkhand is having the very poor food security index, and on this basis, the state has been categorized in four categories. First one is secured, in which the sufficient and enough food grains are available to feed the population, and the quality is also up to the mark. And in this category, the only district is coming is Dhanbad district. And second category is moderately insecure, means in this category there is medium availability of food grains, and status of quality is okay, without any compromise and there is no any issues. So in such category, the states, districts are coming: Sahibganj, Ranchi, Kodarma, Hazaribagh, Dumka, and Godda. Now, third district is categorized as severely insecure. Means in this category districts, there are severe problems, and we are unable to. We are unable to supply the sufficient produce sufficient quantity of food items and other products which is required to the population for normal health and grown up. So the districts which are coming in this category are Gumla, Garhwa, Lohardaga, West Singhbhum, Palamu, Pakur, Deoghar and Bokaro. Now third category is extremely insecure. Means this area is facing lot of problem, and there is the poverty is extreme level, and we are lagging behind to supply the food materials, and the quality is also very poor. So these parts are very suffering from hunger and other issues. So in the districts which are falling in this category are Chatra, East Singhbhum and Giridih. Now here we will discuss the climatic conditions of Jharkhand. The Jharkhand state falls under the agroclimatic zone 7th, which is named as Eastern Plateau and Hilly Region. And the Jharkhand climatic zones are divided in three subzones. The state receives annual rainfall of 1200 to 1600 millimeter, and around 82% of annual rainfalls occurs within monsoon season, which is from mid-June to September. And the climate ranges in Jharkhand is dry semi-humid to humid semi-arid type. The Jharkhand has been divided in three agroclimatic zones. First one is Central and North Eastern Plateau. Second one is Western Plateau zone. And third one is South Eastern Plateau zone. All the regions of the states has been divided on the basis of characteristics as undulating terrain, non-existence of perennial rivers, erratic rainfall system, low water retentive capacity of the soils, low ground water level, high soil erosion, lack of soil and water conservation practices, insufficient agriculture, dairy and fisheries activities, monocropping pattern, low agricultural productivity, pockets experiencing chronic drought conditions, high seasonal unemployment in agriculture, and acute poverty are rampant in all the three regions. Now in this slide, we have gone through the different agroclimatic zones and the districts which are falling in that zone, and description about geographical area, net zone area, irrigated area percent, annual rainfall, and forest area contribution. First, we will discuss about zone Central and Northeastern Plateau zones, which is covering the districts Chatra, Kodarma, Hazaribagh, Ramgarh, Bokaro, Dhanbad, Giridih, Deoghar, Dumka, Pakur, Godda, Jamtara, Sahibganj, and Ranchi. In this zone, the total geographical area is around 35.18 lakh hectares. Net zone area is around 7.12 lakh hectares, and the irrigated area percent of total crop grown zone area is around 11.4%. The annual rainfall is under range 1270 mm, and forest covering area is around 13%. Now we will discuss about second zone, Western Plateau zones, which is covering the districts Garhwa, Palamu, Latehar, Lohardaga, Simdega, Gumla and Khunti. The total geographical area of this zone is around 30.95 lakh hectares. Net zone area is 8 lakh hectares, and irrigated area percent is 12.6%. Annual rainfall ranging around 1246 millimeters, and forest area contribution is 33%. So in Jharkhand, Western Plateau zones is having the highest forest area of 33%. Now, South Eastern Plateau zone, which is covering the districts East Singhbhum, West Singhbhum, and Saraikala Kharsawan, which is having the geographical area of 15.57 lakh hectares. The net zone area is around 2.95 lakh hectares and irrigated area contribution is 7.8% of total zone area and rainfall is around 1400 millimeters and forest area contribution is around 24%. Now we will go through slant features of agroclimatic zones. So first we will discuss about central northeastern plateau zones where there is humid and subhumid tropical monsoon. This zone is constituting around 44% of the total geographical area and this zone is having most densely populated category of Jharkhand and where the population density is around 433 persons per square kilometer and percentage of urbanization is 22%. Second zone is western plateau zones, which is having the humid to subtropical monsoon. This zone is constituting around 39% of the total geographical area and this zone is least urbanized and the percentage of urbanization is only 17%. And this zone is also having the least density population and where the population density is 246 persons per square kilometer. Now we will go through southeastern plateau zones, where is having humid to subtropical monsoon. The region constitute around 17% of total geographical area. It is the most urbanized part of Jharkhand, where urbanization has took place around 35% and the density of population is 299 persons per square kilometer. Now we will discuss characteristics, rainfall patterns and abiotic stresses of different zones. First, we will take central northeastern plateau zones and the characteristics are humid and subhumid tropical monsoon, erratic and uneven distribution of rainfall, late and early cessation of monsoon, coarse textured soils, crust formation on soil surface, low water retention capacity of soil, especially in uplands, lack of safe runoff disposal during monsoon, lack of water harvesting systems and moisture conservation practices, drying of wells and water storage tanks impacting rabi season crop production. Main crops grown in these zones are rice, wheat, maize, ragi, potato, pigeon pea, rapeseed, mustard, gram and pulse crops. We will discuss about rainfall patterns of central northeastern plateau zones. The zone is having rainfall situation and highly depending on monsoon rains, which is erratic and uneven distribution pattern. It is abiotic stresses. These stresses are impacting growth, development, yield and quality of crops. And the main abiotic stress in this zone is uncertainty of rainfall, the drought, which represents water deficit, extreme temperatures is cold, frost and heat, water logging and flooding conditions. After that, related to soil, there is salinity, sodicity problem and mineral toxicity, where there are the percentage of metals and metalloids are higher above the limits and which is impacting the crop growth and production. Now we will discuss characteristic rainfall pattern and abiotic stress factors of western plateau zones. First, we will discuss the characteristics. It is having the humid to subtropical monsoon, erratic and uneven distribution of rainfall. There is late and early cessation of monsoon, low water retention capacity of soils, lack of safe runoff disposal during monsoon, lack of soil and water conservation practices. Main crops grown in this region are rice, maize, barley, lentil, sesamum, groundnut, potato, pigeon pea, gram and pulse crops. Second, we will discuss rainfall patterns. The zone is having high rainfall status, which enables rice cultivation, but totally depending on monsoon rains, which is erratic and uneven distribution pattern. Now we'll discuss about abiotic stresses, which is impacting growth, development, yield, quality of crops, and the main abiotic stress is low fertility status of soil. Now there is southeastern plateau zones characteristic rainfall patterns and abiotic stresses. The characteristics are humid to subtropical monsoon, uneven distribution of rainfall, late and early cessation of monsoon, eroded soils, shallow soil depth and poor fertility of soils, low water holding capacity of soils. Main crops grown are rice, wheat, ragi, pigeon pea and linseed. And the rainfall pattern is having uneven rainfall status. Some rivers are there whose water is used for irrigation purpose. And now abiotic stress. The main abiotic stress is poor soils with low fertility. So now here we have gone through the climatic conditions there and the abiotic factors and other factors of the soil characteristics and the agricultural status of Jharkhand and this rainfall patterns. So now we are coming to the conclusion, there are some scope of development areas where there is need of concerted efforts, and there the areas can be described as first rainwater harvesting, conservation and enhancing water use efficiency, bringing additional land under net zone area under cultivation, amelioration of acidic soils, means there are some acidic soils which we can do the treatment, we can improve and brought under a cultivation category, and crop diversification in upland areas, rice fallow management, horticulture crop improvement, secondary agriculture, post harvest and value addition, where we can develop the techniques, post harvest technique, and we can develop the industries, and we can contribute to these exports, etc., and add value addition to the agriculture, which will play important role for farmers' upliftment in this zone. So this was my presentation regarding the climatic zones, rainfall patterns and abiotic status of different zones of Rajasthan. Hope this presentation will be very, very helpful to all of you. Thank you very much for your kind attention. Here we have shown my YouTube channel details, and we have published the different topics related to seeds and agriculture, and you please go through the link and study for gaining the information. Thank you very much. See you.